Hey everyone, before this video begins, I've made a website which you can check out through the link in the description below. Go check it out, as any support this website can get will help my channel stay alive. Thanks. The average human has a lifespan of about 0.000000316 years. Galactic years, that is. Interestingly, this figure is also close to the length of a nanocentury, at 3.156 seconds, and both come very close to the number of pi. From Bubnov to the Mighty's Veerdrop, here are some of the most peculiar units of measurement that have been used both informally and in everyday science. Let's start big. A foe. This figure is equivalent to 10 to the power of 44 joules, with joules being a measurement of energy. This means that a foe is equivalent to a 1 followed by 44 zeros worth of energy, written like this. So, this insane amount of energy just so happens to be the amount of energy released in a typical supernova explosion within a few seconds. By comparison, our Sun, with its current energy output, would release roughly 1.2 foes over its entire lifetime. So astronomers use this to put these humongous numbers into a measurable comparison rate. So a foe is tremendously huge. Let's see something small now. A banana equivalent dose, or BED. This unit of measurement is informal and describes the amount of radiation you get when eating one banana. Bananas contain a minutely small amount of radioactive material within, but given a truckload of them, it is enough to set off nuclear material detectors at security stations. However, do not let this alarm you. You'll need to eat about 70,000 bananas to get the same amount of radiation a CT scan would give you, and you need to eat 35 million bananas to have a lethal dose of radiation. However, eating 35 million bananas would likely kill you in other ways first. On the theme of radiation, a crab is our next measurement unit. A crab refers to the intensity of the X-ray radiation released by the crab pulsar, the remnant of the star which exploded in a supernova in the year 1054 AD. This unit of measurement is used to calibrate X-ray detectors in space. However, the idea of measuring anything in crabs is an amusing thought. A galactic year is another interesting cosmic measurement unit, as it refers to the time it takes for the Sun to orbit the galactic center. This could take anywhere from 225 million to 250 million years. Using these years, it has been almost 61 and a half years since the beginning of the universe, 17 years since the birth of life, and only 3.5 months since the dinosaurs went extinct. If a galactic year was big, then a nanocentury is tremendously small. This unit of measurement corresponds to just 1 billionth of a century, or 3.156 seconds. This term is used by IBM in reference to the maximum amount of time they would ideally make a user wait for a computer response. Interestingly, 1 billionth of a century is very close to the value of pi. Going from ludicrously small, we come across a geological term, the Bubnov unit. 1 Bubnov is equivalent to the speed of 1 meter in a million years, named after Serge von Bubnov, a German geologist. This measurement term is useful when measuring the rate of land erosion. For example, the average rate of erosion on Earth is 30 Bubnov units, or 30 meters of land eroded per million years. However, this rate can vary, with rivers going into the thousands of Bubnovs, or millimeters per year of erosion. Sverdrop takes us into the territory of huge measurements again, as we are now looking at the oceans. A Sverdrop measures the rate of flow of 1 million cubic meters of water per second. This measurement type is mainly used by oceanographers for measuring the huge amounts of water that is transported in currents. A micromort has a value of 1 in a million chance of death. So, if you decide to go scuba diving, you expose yourself to 5 micromorts. While climbing Mount Everest has a deadly 37,932 micromort exposure amount. One micromort is gained from smoking 1.4 cigarettes, while drinking half a glass of wine is also equivalent to a 1 micromort gain. Finally, a Muggelsegeli is known as a very small unit of length in Germany, referring to the size of a housefly's reproductive organs. I think I'm going to leave this video here. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all again before the next galactic year, and make sure to check out the website. The link is in the description below.